All right, welcome to round two. Kept this hand on the draw, pretty reasonable. Got a couple lands, pile of essence scatters. Hopefully give us time to hit these later drops. Claustrophobia 2. Sweet little removal spell. Messenger Drake into Colossal Whale. I really like Messenger Drake. That's exactly the sort of card that I want in this type of deck. I'm glad Wizards printed it. Jace. Can't be upset with that draw, even though we need lands. Waiting for Pi. I am waiting for Pi. Pi sounds awesome. Apple Pie would just be the actual best. If any of you at home wants to send me an apple pie, message me on Facebook and I will send you my address. I love pie. Congregate. Not what I was hoping to draw. Not like remotely close to what I was hoping to draw there. Essence Scatter you. Yeah, I get you. Let's see a land. Bam, not a land. Pass the turn. So, magic, right? How about that? Oh my god. Is he tribal vampires? Like, I'm actually the zombie. He's tribal zombies? He hasn't even played a zombie. He only has three cards in hand. How big can that Dwarf Destinies reasonably get? Come on. Yeah. So, I would actually rather hold up Essence Scatter than play the Seacoast Drake at the moment, which means that I'm going to discard, which is fine. I didn't need this Congregate anyway. Man. You have my hand. Alright. Nightwing Shade. Yeah. Essence Scatter that. Oh, maybe he just has something that produces a pile of zombies. Alright, well, I'm out of Essence Scatters. Hope I draw that third land sometime soon. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. This is one of the reasons I love playing control decks with, like, really cheap removal. Oh, I take this stop off my... Because even though we're, like, missing our fourth land drop, we're still very alive. So our opponent's all flooded out and stuff. We have some removal spells. What's actually going to happen is this game, my opponent is going to get to 10 swamps, and then he's going to double the one that deals damage for the equal to number of swamps you play. Such with the C. God, I'm so bad with names. But anyway, he's just gonna like double 10 me and that'll be the end of it. Trading post. Discard a card, gain 4 life. Pay a life, get a 0/1 goat token. Turn an artifact. Okay, he's probably just gonna start sacrificing artifacts to draw cards. But imagine, like, that's probably why he's playing all this crap. Yeah, he instantly sacrifices his quarter shield to draw a card. And it's that swamp he needed. Yay, go opponent. Is that dark stealing we needed? Then next turn I'm just gonna play Jace. Elm 10. Oh, he's got something. Nope, he's just drawing a card. So if his plan was to double 10 me, he is now too late. I mean, yeah, he would have already cast it. Yep, so just gonna mill him 10. Oh my god, does he have options? So he can just sacrifice a creature. So he needs to draw a creature so that he can sacrifice it to get back Elixir of Immortality. Because otherwise he will deck. Okay, he did have Corrupt. And that's the name of it, Corrupt. That card name I was looking for. So the good news is I'm not getting double corrupted. Bad news is he's at 26 life. And it's going to be very hard to kill him in time. I kind of want to just slam this Colossal Whale. Yep, doing that. What could go wrong? Most people would just like run out some other flyers that are also threats. But the more turns I give him, the more activations he gets off of his trading post. And so maybe I'm a little too afraid of that. Mono black control, eh? Yep. Pretty okay with him playing an Accursed Spirit here. Even if he deals with my Colossal Whale, then I still can claustrophobia the thing. In fact, I'm going to do it pre-combat just so he can't block. So far in this draft, I definitely wish I had main decked in the gate. That is something that I wish I had done. Yep, sacrifice goat, return Elixir of Immortality. Wouldn't it be insane if I just like played another memory adept, just like Jace Millie 10, like, gotcha. Idiot, what were you thinking? Yeah, I'm going to play out the Messenger Drake now. A bit more resilient to removal than the Air Servant. Slightly less of a clock. I don't think the difference between a 4-3 and a 3-3 is going to matter here, but if it does, then it'll be my fault. And I don't even know if the Colossal Whale should exile his Accursed Spirit. Probably not. Okay, he's doing something main phase. Okay, returning the Door of Destiny so we can draw a card next turn. Yeah, because if he's going to crack the Elixir of Immortality, then he'll lose the artifact value that's already in his graveyard. Doesn't even have that many zombies. I think his actual win condition is Corrupt You, shuffle back in Corrupt with Elixir of Immortality, eventually draw it again while cycling through my deck with Trading Post. His deck actually looks sweet. Like, he has to Diabolic Tutor to find either the Trading Post or the Elixir. Oh no, Grim Return. Yeah, that's fine. Especially because I can just bottom it, or exile it with the Colossal Whale. Which I'm pretty sure is the correct play. If I was him, I would have held on to that Grim Return. And we are actually pretty close to racing. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have Lethal on board, but he can gain 5, so we don't actually have Lethal. I think we have to play out this Air Servant. Try and deny him draw steps. So he's going to have 2 draws towards Corrupt or Diabolic Tutor. But hopefully those are the only two cards that do anything. Definitely the only two cards that we see in his graveyard that do anything. So that's the good news. We're probably going to see Trading Post cracking the door here to draw a card. Oh, he's going to discard a card to gain 4 life, maybe? Put him up to 18. We have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Oh, we don't actually have Lethal in play, so we have to force him to discard the card, burning up the Sea Kite. He just missed that. Like, all he had to do was activate his Trading Post, and then he would have had another turn and, like, two more draw steps to hit a Corrupt, and then kill my Colossal Whale. I don't know. Maybe he miscounted. Maybe he thought he was fine. He just wasn't. So Solemn Offering seems insane against him. Not insane or anything, but he is playing an engine deck. Negate, also very good. I might bring in the Millstone. And once again, we're gonna maybe cut these Congregates and Angelic Accords. make my sweet little Make Some Angels engine. And Illusionary Armor is actually playable against him as well. Because we actually didn't see that much removal, which is kind of strange. And then Claustrophobia can get cut. I think Pacifism is slightly better. Capuchin Knight. Even for Essence Scatter. And that seems pretty decent. A little bit more aggressive. And then some more anti-control elements in the Negate and the Solemn Offering and the Millstone.